In this video, what we want to do next is start using those molar masses that you've been practicing calculations for in what we call mole conversions. So there are a lot of places where you'll be doing mole conversions. One of the most common ones that come up in chemistry as we continue to study reactions is converting between moles of something and grams of, or mass of that same substance. So switching back and forth between grams and moles of any given substance should be a relatively easy one-step conversion that you should get really good at. This is the first step of many, many problems. It's also the last step of many problems that we do. But you're going to see it's sort of an important little leg or section of larger chemistry problems that we'll be doing a lot of as we look at second semester. And if you consider going into AP chemistry, there's a lot of this stuff involved there too. So as we look at gram-mole conversions, hopefully you have this sheet. And if you don't, you can follow along, copy these problems down into your notes or anywhere else, and it'll work just the same. So if you happen to have this page, great. If not, copy these down on a different page someplace and just follow along with us the best you can. So I just want to go through a number of examples with you on this one and pick out some of various kinds of problems and use some different masses and things along the way. I'm going to jump through a little bit of the molar mass calculation because hopefully by now that's something that you've been practicing a bit of, and just show you how to set these problems up and do the conversions. So on number one, we have 985 grams of sodium chloride, and what this is asking me to do is convert this to moles. So simply on this sheet, make the following conversions and show your work. So I want to take 985 grams of sodium chloride and convert that into moles of sodium chloride. This is no different than converting, say, 15 inches into feet. If, as long as you know how many inches are in 1 foot, you can make that conversion. And the same idea here, as long as I know how many grams are in 1 mole, I can make this conversion too. So we start with 985 grams of sodium chloride, and I jot that down first. Now what I want to do is sort of set up what we call conversion steps or conversion ratios, or sometimes you'll hear them called conversion factors, also known as the what we call the factor label method. And as we go through the rest of second semester chemistry, you'll hear this referred to a lot of times as stoichiometry. Basically what it is a way of arranging your numbers to show ratios or equalities and use those things in converting from one substance or quantity to another substance quantity. So what I do is I put the substance that are the amount that I'm given in the top left corner of this little kind of organizational box. Underneath of it, I'm going to leave that box empty. But over here, I'm going to put in this particular space an equality statement. And that equality statement is going to be something that relates grams of sodium chloride to moles of sodium chloride. Now, in the previous work that we've done, we've looked at how we calculate molar mass. And I can go to the periodic table and find out that sodium chloride, if I add it up, is about 58.44 grams per mole. So 58.44 grams per 1 mole is an equality statement, just like 12 inches per 1 foot. Now what I want to do is put that equality statement in these boxes next to my original amount, 985 grams. So in this box, I want to think about putting something on the top that's equal to something on the bottom. For example, 1 mole of sodium chloride, as I just added up on my periodic table, is equal to, and I'm just going to put a little equal sign in between to remind me, is equal to 58.44 grams of sodium chloride. Now you don't need to put the equal sign there, but that's what we're sort of saying by positioning these numbers in these two spaces. 1 mole of sodium chloride is equal to 58.44 grams of sodium chloride. Now it would be true if I flipped it over too, right? If I flipped this over and said 58.44 grams of sodium chloride was equal to 1 mole, it'd be the same thing. 12 inches is equal to 1 foot, 1 foot is equal to 12 inches, 1 day is 24 hours, 24 hours is equal to 1 day. It works both ways. The reason I put them in there this way is because I want to get my units to cancel out. And by that I mean my grams of sodium chloride on the top over here are going to cancel out with grams of sodium chloride on the bottom in the next box, just like x over x might cancel out in math, or x squared or whatever units it might be. So as I do my conversion now, I'm going to punch this in my calculator as 985 times 1, which you don't really need to do, but we can. So 985 times 1 divided by 58.44. So in my calculator, and you don't need to write this out, but I'm going to go ahead and write it out just this one time, maybe once or twice. 985 times 1 divided by 58.44. That's essentially what we're doing here. Okay, just like I divide 15 inches by 12, if I was going to convert it into feet. So 985 divided by 58.44, and I get my calculator to give me an answer of around 16.85489. It just keeps on going. How do I round this off? We're going to talk more about the rules of what we call significant figures and rounding, but because 985 has three digits in it, that are measured mass of sodium chloride digits. I'm going to go ahead and round my answer off. So it too has three measured 16.8548. I'm going to round that off to 16.9 and call it 16.9. Now what's the label? Because grams canceled out of my math over here, I'm left with moles of sodium chloride as the unit on my work. And what do you know? That's what they wanted me to get here. How many moles of sodium chloride? So 16.9 moles of NaCl. That would be my answer for number one. Okay. Simplest conversion is that. Okay. I'm going to do another one with you on number two here. So again, I want to start with 0.32 grams of magnesium fluoride. And I'm going to put a little box there. And again, I'm going to need an equality statement putting these two boxes. So I go to my periodic table and I add up MgF2. Now you can take a moment and do that if you'd like, but if you feel like you know how to do that, you can trust my numbers. I'm going to use 62.30 for my mass here. 62.30 grams of MgF2 per mole. And so in my next boxes, I'm going to go ahead and say that one mole of MgF2 is equal to 62.30 grams of MgF2. And be sure to label things really thoroughly, because as we go into chemistry problems that get more and more kind of elaborate, sometimes we have more units going on there that we can keep track of if we don't label them. It's important that you do. So here I'm going to punch this in my calculator as 0.32 divided by 62.30. All right. And my calculator is going to give me an answer that's pretty small. And that makes sense because I'm dividing a pretty small mass by a pretty large one. And so I'm going to get a pretty small answer. In fact, my calculator says the answer is 0.0051. Okay. And again, I say because this 32 is two measured digits, then I'm going to go ahead and round my answer off to two measured digits as well. 0.0051. The 5 and the 1 are my measured values here. And don't worry if you're a little confused about how we know how to round things off. Just for now, I would say write down a couple extra digits as a good general rule. And later on, we can always show you how to round them off a little bit more cleanly and consistently. There are very specific rules about how we round things off when we're doing math and chemistry. And we'll introduce you more to those as we continue to go forward if you haven't already learned about them already. And if you do know the rules, then you should be rounding these without even having to think too much about it. Now, I want to go through an example like number three where we start with moles. So let's look at number three. For this one, we've got 2.5 moles of NO2. Now, in a lot of problems we'll do in chemistry, you'll start with grams and convert to moles, like we did in the last two problems. But we can just as easily convert from moles to grams. All right. So, again, in these boxes, I want to put an equality statement. And if I go to the question here, I'm trying to convert from moles to grams. So, I'd like to have an equality statement that connects moles to grams. Well, we know we can add up NO2 in the periodic table and get its molar mass. That's 46.01. In fact, if you did the other homework with the mole conversions, or the molar masses, you may have already added most of these up, because some of these are the ones that are on that same sheet. So you can just look over there and you've already got the molar masses done. If not, go to your table, add them up. So NO2 is 46.01 grams per mole. Now, when I put it in my boxes here, I still want to put in one mole is equal to 46.01 grams. But I'm going to put it in the other way this time. In other words, I'm going to say one mole of NO2 is equal to 46.01 grams of NO2. Now, why did I flip it? Well, it's still true, right? 46 grams equals one mole. That's still true. Just like these other ones up here were true. But I put mole on the bottom this time because I want my units to cancel out. So moles of NO2 and moles of NO2 will now cancel out. If I'd put it in there the other way, I would have moles next to moles. And on the bottom, I would have grams. And nothing would cancel out. I would have moles squared over grams. And that doesn't even make any sense in the light of what we're trying to do with these units. So you want to try to position things in these boxes so that units will cancel out. Moles of NO2 on the top? Well, then I want moles of NO2 on the bottom and something else on the top. In this case, I know that my equality statement says that one mole is equal to 46.01 grams. So there it is. Put that on the top, one mole on the bottom, and off I go. But now, instead of punching this into my calculator as a division, I'm going to be more or less doing this as a multiplication statement. This is 2.5 times 46.01. Now, if you want, you can also say divided by 1, right? because that's underneath. But we really don't need to do that because we know dividing by 1 doesn't change anything. So 2.5 times 46.01 here divided by 1, and my answer comes out to be about 115 grams of NO2. Or if we want to round it off, so that's appropriate by our rounding rules, we would actually round this off to about 120 grams of NO2. And again, for now, if you're a little confused about those rounding rules, don't worry too much about it. But it would be about 120 grams of NO2. Or if you said 115 for now, I'd be all right with that too. Okay. So that's converting from moles to grams. Now let's do one mole, like one mole. Let's do one more like that. Let's look at number 5. So I have here 6.0 moles of zinc, and I want to convert that into grams. 6.0 moles of zinc. All right, let's make our box again. And again, I want an equality statement. Well, zinc's an easy one because it's just an element. So I go to my periodic table and look at zinc. I don't have to even add anything up this time. It's 65.38 grams of zinc per mole. And so in my boxes over here, I'm going to put that equality statement, 65.38 grams of zinc per 1 mole of zinc. And again, that's the equality statement. And so when I go to punch this in, will my units cancel out? Yep, moles on the top, moles on the bottom. So those have canceled out and those units are gone. Essentially, I've got 6.0 times 65.38, right? And again, divided by 1, which we don't really need to do. But 6 times 65.38, it's going to be around 390 or so. And we'll punch it into our calculator and get an answer, but 6 times 65.38 gives me an answer of 392.28. And if I'm going to round that off, I'm going to say 392, or about 390 grams of zinc. Again, I'm rounding based on the fact that 6.0 has two what we call significant figures. And so my answer at the end should have two significant figures, 3 and a 9. But if you're not clear on that rounding, you could say 392. I'd be comfortable with that. Okay? So that's a conversion from moles into grams. So let's do one more, and then I'll let you be to work on some for yourself. All right? Let's jump down to one that's a little bit bigger looking. So number 9's got Na2SO4. I'm going to convert 150 grams of Na2SO4 into moles. So I'm going to need my box here. And I'm going to need an equality statement. Well, go to my periodic table and add things up. Na2SO4 off my periodic table gives me a mass of 142.04. Two decimal places is a good minimum when you're adding them up off the periodic table. So 142.04. Now, that's grams per 1 mole. So again, where am I going to put things in my box over here? The way I always encourage students to think about it is, whenever possible, bring the units that you have down and to the right so that they'll cancel out in the next step. So I have grams of sodium sulfate. I'm going to bring down grams of sodium sulfate and put them in the next box so that they kind of are going to cancel out naturally. But what numbers go in front of them? Well, 142.04 grams in 1 mole of that sodium sulfate. Okay? You should find that you have 1 mole in a lot. 1 mole, 1 mole, 1 mole. Not 142.04 moles, but 1 mole equals something. That's almost always the case when we're doing mole conversions of any kind or working with the mole. You're often going to find that 1 mole equals something. And 1 in front of mole gets to be sort of this natural thing. And more often than not, it's the right thing. So here we have 150 divided by 142.04. It's going to be about 1 mole, right? Because 142 grams is 1 mole. We have just a little bit more than that. So if I do the math and let my calculator tell me what we've got exactly here, it comes out to be 1.056 moles of sodium sulfate. Okay, 1.056. And here again, I've gone with my rounding rules to match the original number, but that would be approximately the right answer, so a little bit more than 1 mole. So I've shown you a few problems where we're converting from grams to moles, and a few problems where we're converting from moles to grams. What I want you to do is work on the rest of the problems that are on here and keep on going through. And on this particular sheet, if you've got it, OK, Okay, these are all problems that go between grams and moles and nothing else. There are other kinds of mole conversions that are coming at a different time. But for now, whoops, I'm sliding around. For now, we'll stick with grams and moles. For the purposes of this video and this sheet, just to zero in on one kind of conversion for now. So again, if you have this sheet, go ahead and work on it right through to the end. And the next time we're together, we'll check it again with the answer key and see if there's anything that stumped you. Again, never hurts to punch your math in twice, double check. But if you trust yourself and your calculator, more times than not, you're going to get it right the first time. So set them up, add up those molar masses, watch those labels, grams and moles, so that they cancel out correctly and leave us with the units that we want. The answer that you get, the unit that you want, is almost always going to be the one that's right here in that last box on the top after everything else has canceled out, leaving you with just one unit left over. One, here we got moles. Here we've got grams, and that should match what you've been asked to find. Take your time with them, show your work. You always have to show your work on these to get full credit. Make sure you're showing those, setting it up, and label things neatly. If this isn't enough room, I think it is, but if this isn't enough room, feel free to work on a different sheet and show your work neatly, whatever you need for that to happen. Thanks, and I'll see you the next time.